Yo,
what's up? I'm Adam.
And I'm Sekou.
And Sekou's here to help us understand a lot of things about wireframing and Figma and how that can help with Power BI dashboards. I did a video not too long ago with Mara where she mentioned Figma. Sekou, I had to call you and just figure out what this was all about because I don't know anything about it. But before we get into that, Sekou, tell us a little bit about yourself and what you do.
Well, hey, thanks for the call, Adam. I appreciate it, you know, here to save the day with Figma and all things reported. But I'm Sekou Tyler, one of the directors at Lovelytics, and really excited to show you how to use Figma to enhance your reporting.
So where do we begin? Like, tell me about what this wireframing process is. And
yeah, so Figma is a great tool. It's a third-party tool. The concept of wireframing is a UX UI process. So basically what you would do, you know what? Actually, before we do all that, we know how we do.
Yeah, head over to the machine. Let's go.
So now I'm in Figma right now, and this is what it looks like. It's a blank canvas to where you can start doing your wireframing process.
I talk about blank pages all the time, so this excites me.
So you have your blank canvas, and what you really want to do is, one, you want to design to what you'll be building out in Power BI. So if we go into Power BI itself, what you want to do is go into your canvas settings and look at your width and height or the type that you've selected. So if you're doing 16 by 9, that translates to 1280 and 720 in Figma. Mm-hmm. So if we were to come back into Figma, and typically in Figma, you want to create a frame. So there's two ways you can do it. If I select the frame button up here, you'll see a lot of pre-built selections to your right. So if you're developing for a phone, a tablet, a desktop, whatever it is, they have pre-built functionality. So if I were to come in here and select 16 by 9, it would have that pre-built for me. And so if I wanted to adjust my specs to say 1280 by 720, I can do that. And now I have a frame selected. And if you come in here and you can change the name of it, another way to do that is if you just wanted to use a rectangle, you can come in here and select your objects here, and I can select a rectangle and create that blank frame on here. Again, using the same specs, 90 by 720, we now have our blank canvas that would be the same size of our Power BI report. And if I right click on here and select frame selection, now we see that we have a new frame. And so the importance of creating a frame is that now as you add more objects, they're all grouped together within your frame. So if I want to come in here and start building out additional context or information, I could come in here and bring a rectangle in here. I could bring in a text box or a star or whatever it is I want to pull in. I could bring that in here. And then if you look at the left side, you see you have all the attributes in your frame. So it gives you flexibility to understand your grouping and what it is that you're bringing in. But now we're going to walk through the wireframer process of starting from a blank canvas to actually building out a wireframe that you can give your stakeholders and for them to get approval.
And this is automatically going to get me a beautiful report, right?
Yeah, automatically. You know,
I keep hearing about all this AI stuff, right? This is just this. That's not this. Okay.
Yeah. No. Not what we're doing right now, but they could be working on something to type it out. All right. So we have our blank canvas. We have our blank frame. So if we scroll down in here, let's zoom in a little bit. Before we just had our blank canvas that was a white screen, and then now we have different attributes. We're starting to really work on the dashboard itself or the report itself and how it is that we want to place different things. So if we look at our elements that are on here, we have our logos. We also have any text fields. We kind of have our box. We have text information. We kind of have a layout of where we want our visuals to go. And so now we're starting the process like, all right, how do we iterate and continue on this? So if we scroll down, now we want to start adding data-driven elements onto our wireframe. So what we want to do is add any type of data. So if there's a refresh date on here, we can add that as a text area. So we're saying here, here's our data. Now, if there's any filters, a lot of slices on here. And then now we want to build this and start iterating on this and make this more of a high fidelity wireframe. And what that looks like is now we want to actually start adding visualizations to show what our report will visually look like. There are different ways you can do that. Like I mentioned earlier, there are different elements that you can have added on here. And this one, we brought in our actual bar charts. We're just using a rectangle and we're doing some coloring, and then we're having text fields and then just bringing in different information. So now we can start visually showing what our report will look like.
You basically are adding shapes to visually represent the data that's going to be there. So there's no real data here. We're just mocking this up. Kind of sell the end product without having to do all the work to get the end product.
Exactly. We're building out these mock-ups with fake data, not realistic data, but to get the visual buy-in from the stakeholders or the clients to say, hey, visually, does this represent what you want? And then it makes everybody happy in the end, yeah. right? The stakeholders yeah. sign off, the developers know what they're developing.
And it's easier to iterate on this than like the final product where we got to re-engineer a whole bunch of stuff.
Yes. Also, another thing in Figma is you can have particular libraries of colors that you can use. Let's say I don't like these colors at all. I can select on a single element that I want and go to fill, and I can change the color that I want. So if there's a color scheme that your organization is using, you can automatically embed that in the Figma and you can have that as your core colors. And another thing that you can do as well is, right, we're copy and paste. We know we want these four charts across the board. If you're used to the selection panel in Power BI, you'll see that these are the items that have been selected. So if I come in here, right click and select group selection, we'll see that a group has been created based on my selection. Nice. Now I can copy and paste that group and paste it right here. And now that group is done. So, you know, in 5 seconds, if I wanted to across the board, I could literally have, you know, copy and paste my visuals, change the colors, and I have a working product that I could potentially pass out to our stakeholders.
Nice.
Here's an example of what a finished product could look like. We have our information filled out. We have the colors quickly filled in, and then we have a map. This is a JPEG, an image. So if you have any images or anything that you want to put in place, you can also do that. But again, we could pass this. Now we could download this and give this to our clients and stakeholders, and it's easier to iterate on this, like you said, Adam, than it is on a finished product.
Absolutely. I was going to ask about that map because I was like, man, your drawing skills are great. But no, you're just, just copying and pasting. And that's fine. Like on Guy in a Cube, man, we're not lazy. We're just efficient. So
efficient.
I love it. So we've got buy-in. We've got these items. Then like, how do we take this wireframe and go to like the actual report?
Yeah. So once we have all the buy-in, now what we want to do is actually start developing towards it. So what we can do is go to our frame that we have built out. And if you click on your frame, you can export that frame. There are different options. We're going to export this as an SVG, and we're going to export that frame and have it saved locally. And so now, once you go back into Power BI, if you were to come in here and create your Canvas background with that frame, come in here and select it. Now you have the frame that you had built out with everything agreed upon. And then now as you create your visuals, you have a guideline of where your visuals can go in your Power BI report. So I already built out one of the maps. I have it here in the place that it should be at. But as you can see, now it's built out and everything is great. And now I could just iterate on here. I could build my bar charts that I have. I could put my text-driven attributes up here and everything that we agreed upon amongst the wireframe. And it just helps with the process of getting a finished product out there.
That's bananas. One thing I will call out though, I noticed you had text in the background image. So folks watching, just be careful about that from an accessibility standpoint. So screen readers won't be able to read that because it's just part of the image. So that's something to consider if you're building reports. So now like we're talking about Figma. It's a tool that's out there. I believe they have a free option that's there.
Yeah. So there is a free option where you can try it out as a personal user. You can go out there and if you want to scale it, they do have licensing options for you as well.
You know, Patrick did this video a while back of how to do like a background image with PowerPoint. So PowerPoint's definitely something you can do this with as well. I would say Figma is probably meant for this kind of thing, though. So it's a little easier to like the options that it has and the capabilities it has go way beyond what PowerPoint can do. So I definitely recommend checking out Figma and seeing if this helps with your report design needs. Well, awesome, Sekou. I appreciate you going through this. Where can people find you like for stuff that you're creating to learn more about what you do?
Yeah, follow me on YouTube, Sekou, Sekou, S-Q-L-S-E-K-O-U. I have a blog as well, and I'm on social media. I even have a TikTok, but I barely do anything on TikTok. Feel free to follow me on there.
Awesome. And we'll have links down in the description below for all of those items. So Sekou, thanks for being here. And folks, if you're watching and you want more great content about Power BI, check out some recommended video that's sitting up above me. Thanks for watching. Keep being awesome. And we'll see you in the next video.